This is not advice. I'm not your advisor. Sipping on Gatorade. Answering questions. Once you invest enough to get the company match on your 401k, should you start a Roth IRA or just invest more in the 401k? You're pretty new to personal finance. You've been reading I Will Teach You to Be Rich. I like that book. And he seems to insist on starting a Roth IRA even if you have a 401k. I don't know if he really insists on anything, but sure. Why is it beneficial to have both? Is the IRA generally considered better? Would the compounding interest of adding more to your 401k make you more money long term? Interesting questions. Okay. So I'm going to actually do them in reverse. Compounding interest does not work that way the way that you're implying. Putting more in there does not make a difference. You can split it up. Compounding will still work the exact same way. So you can put $5,000 a year into 401k in an IRA, and compounding will work the same as if you put $10,000 into just one of them. Is the IRA generally considered better? Just IRA versus 401k? The answer is yes. An IRA is more flexible and therefore theoretically better. Now, you asked about a Roth IRA. So from your question, I'm not sure you understand the difference. So I'll tell you. Roth IRA, you don't get a deduction for on your taxes the year you put it in. You pay tax on that money. You never pay tax on it again. You don't pay tax on the earnings. You don't pay tax when you take it out. 401k, assuming it's traditional, you aren't paying tax on it the year you earn it. You aren't paying tax as it grows, but you do pay tax when you take it out. That means if you are right now, when you make the contribution, in a relatively low tax bracket for yourself for the rest of your life, Roth contributions would be better than 401k contributions. If you are earning a lot compared to what you are going to earn in the future, including in your retirement, then traditional, either IRA or 401k, is better right now. It sounds like you're probably just starting off. You're probably in a relatively low tax bracket compared to what you'll be farther in your career. So the Roth IRA is probably, sounds like, the place where money should be going next. You should be getting the match, and you should be putting it into the Roth IRA. Over time, you'll be maxing that out. A Roth IRA, you can only put $6,000 a year into. So after that, you go back to the 401k anyway. And it's really likely your 401k will end up bigger than your Roth, which is how it is for most people and makes a lot of sense. I hope that helps. Are we overinsured? My spouse and I both work. Current combined income of $228,000, each bringing in about half. You got a small mortgage and two small children. Moving to a higher cost of living area, your income will go up to $330,000, and your mortgage will be around $500,000. You carry $1 million in life insurance on each. That's a reasonable amount. And a combination of whole and term life. You trust your planner, but you think she may be more conservative. She will soon ask you to increase your whole life using an OPAI. I don't even know what that is. Hang on. All right, I looked it up. Option to purchase additional insurance. It's like a big red flag to even know what that is. I've never even heard of it. So you must have heard it before from them. You pay $1,100 a month in life insurance alone. That is a shitload. How much of this is whole life? You started purchasing life insurance well into your upper 30s. Are you overpaying? Well, it depends what you mean by overpaying. I mean, you're getting whole life insurance for it, but whole life insurance usually sucks. Your monthly situation also seems crazy. I'd be surprised if anyone else had a similar situation. I'm sure plenty of people do, but no one you know is going to have it, and they're probably not going to admit it, even if they do. I don't know why you need a whole life insurance. You should... It sounds like you should just have all term insurance, because eventually you're not going to need it, assuming you're saving. But the $1 million each doesn't seem that unreasonable for how much you guys earn, how much you guys are going to have in a mortgage, the fact that you got kids. That strikes me as reasonable, but it should all be term, from what it says here. In most cases, term is the way to go. You should look up how much the term would be. It'd probably be it might even be $200 a month each. It doesn't say how old you are, but yeah, $1 million of term insurance, not so expensive. All right, so this website's called Policy Genius. I don't know if it's great, but the numbers look about right to me. And it says average cost of life insurance for a 20-year term for $1 million, $50 a month each. So you two could each have a policy for like $100 a month for term. Yeah, that's what I would do. Probably going to need to get someone to help you out with how to dump that whole life policy, because, I don't know, this advisor does not seem, seems questionable. Seems very questionable. To hold just found Bitcoin or to S&P 500. Just managed to get access to your Bitcoin wallet. You're wondering if you should keep it or cash it out and put it in the S&P 500. I don't know, man. Which one's going to go up more? Why'd you buy the Bitcoin to start with?